Good morning. My name is Jason Greenblatt. I'm an assistant to the President of the United States of America and Special Representative for International Negotiations. I'm pleased to be here this morning with Israeli Minister for Regional Cooperation, Tsachi Hanegbi, and the head of the Palestinian Water Authority, Mazen Gunim, as well as their colleagues, to announce an important step forward on the Red Dead Conveyance Project. I'd like to welcome my colleagues, Ambassador David Friedman and Consul General Don Blum, and I'd like to acknowledge the important contribution of their hardworking teams at the embassy, at the consulate, the U.S. Agency for International Development, as well as our colleagues at the U.S. State Department and the White House National Security Council. As we all know, water is a precious commodity in the Middle East. The United States welcomes the agreement reached by the Palestinian Authority and the Government of Israel, which will allow for the sale of up to 33 million cubic meters of water from Israel to the Palestinian Authority. In addition, we hope that this deal will contribute to the healing of the Dead Sea, and that it will help not only Palestinians and Israelis, but Jordanians as well. President Trump has made it clear that working toward achieving a lasting peace agreement between Israelis and Palestinians is a top priority for him. This agreement is an example of the parties working together to make a mutually beneficial deal. In fact, this is the second important agreement reached between the Israelis and Palestinians this week, the first being the agreement to energize the Jenin electrical substation, which was signed on Monday. That agreement came about with the strong support of the Trump administration and other international partners, and provides another example of cooperation between Israelis and Palestinians that will lead to economic improvements in the lives of Palestinians, who have now, in the span of 1 week, benefited from agreements that provide key improvements in the critical areas of water and electricity. I am proud of the role that the United States and our international partners have played in helping the parties reach this deal, and I hope that it is a harbinger of things to come. I'd like to thank you for joining us here today, and I'm going to introduce Minister Tsachi Hanegbi to say a few words, after which the head of the Palestinian Water Authority, Mazen Gunim, will speak, and then they'll be able to answer some questions. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jason. Minister Ghanim Abu Fadi, Ambassador Friedman, General Counsel Don, my General Director, Dr. Drasnin, friends from both delegations, and ladies and gentlemen from the press. Unfortunately, in our neighborhood, not every morning we have a reason to smile. This morning we do, because after years of stalemate, and thanks to the passionate mediation of Jason Greenblatt, and thanks to the pragmatic and professional approach of both delegations, the Palestinian headed by Mazen Ghanim and the Israeli delegation, we reached an important agreement. This agreement allows us to launch the Red Dead project that is a crucial project for Jordan, for Israel, and for the Palestinian Authority. I'm sure many of you know that the Red Dead project is the biggest, most ambitious project ever initiated and exercised in our area. And it will supply significant amount of water to Jordan, to Israel, and to the Palestinians. It will help us challenge the biggest problem that the Dead Sea is facing, evaporation of a meter every year. And it will also produce green energy. So all of us in this room proved last night that water can serve as means for reconciliation, for prosperity, for cooperation, rather than be a cause for tension and dispute. I want to thank you, Jason. I know how much you were engaged in this issue since our meeting, both Abu Fadi, myself, and you, in Brussels, that you initiated. I want to thank the American administration for assisting this project as a whole and also being involved in the negotiation that we held the last several months. And I'm convinced that a Ministry of Regional Cooperation, with the assistance of the United States administration and with the cooperation of our neighbors, the Palestinians, the Jordanians, and hopefully other neighbors, will be able to enhance the great vision of regional cooperation for the well-being of the people of the Middle East. Thank you.
Thank you. I will speak in Arabic. Welcome. I want to welcome all of you. Zayed Greenblatt, Wazir Hanegbi, السيدات والسادة الحضور اسمحوا لي بداية أن أتقدم بالشكر الجزيل إلى حكومة الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية ممثلة بالسيد غرينبلات المبعوث الخاص لعملية السلام لمنطقة الشرق الأوسط لرعايته الكريمة لهذا الحدث الهام وهو توافق الجانبين الإسرائيلي والفلسطيني.
So first of all, he would like to welcome welcome all the guests, Mr. Greenblatt, Mr. Hanegbi, and express appreciation to the U.S. government represented by Mr. Greenblatt for their support.
توافق الجانبين الفلسطيني والإسرائيلي على تنفيذ ما ورد في مذكرة التفاهم الموقعة في 9 كانون الأول 2013. بين الأطراف الثلاثة المشاطئة للبحر الميت فلسطين والأردن وإسرائيل.
So today there will be a signing of an agreement based on a memorandum of understanding which was signed on the 9th of December. Which year, excuse me? Yeah. 2013.
والجزئية الخاصة بحصول الجانب الفلسطيني على حصته المائية من المرحلة الأولى من المشروع اللي هو مشروع التعاون الإقليمي لقناة البحرين البحر الأحمر بحر الميت.
The most important of which is the part which Palestinians will have their share in this regional project of the Red Sea.
والتي كانت مقدرة من 20 ل 30 مليون متر مكعب من نظام التحلية الإسرائيلي على البحر الأبيض المتوسط.
According to the Israeli desalination project on the Mediterranean Sea, it's estimated between 20 million. Yeah, 20 to 30 million cubic meters.
فبعد مناقشات طويلة استمرت أكثر من عام ونصف بين الجانبين بين الطواقم الفنية الإسرائيلية والطواقم الفنية الفلسطينية وبرعاية أمريكية مشكورة وهنا نؤكد يعني ونشكر كافة الطواقم الأمريكية بدون استثناء ابتداء من سيد غرينبلات اللي أشرف بشكل مباشر على هذا الموضوع سعادة القنصل دونالد بلامب وكافة الطواقم الأمريكية في القدس.
So he's thanking the whole American team starting from Mr. Greenblatt, Consul General Donald Blum and everyone for supervising this agreement, which it took in discussion more than a long of between the two parties.
واللي على أساسها يعني تم التوافق على أن يقوم الجانب الإسرائيلي بتزويد الجانب الفلسطيني ب 32 مليون متر مكعب.
Based on which it was agreed that the Israeli side will provide the Palestinian side 32 million cubic meters.
22 مليون في الضفة الغربية و10 مليون لقطاع غزة.
It will be divided between 22 million cubics and the West Bank and 10 million cubic in Gaza.
تأكيد أن هذا سيخفف من معاناة الشعب الفلسطيني التي تتفاقم في بداية كل صيف والانقطاعات والأزمة الكبيرة التي تعيشها كافة المناطق الفلسطينية اليوم دون استثناء.
Which will alleviate sufferings of Palestinians they surely face, especially when summer begins and all sectors suffer from.
طبعا أيضا سيخفف عن معاناة أهلنا في قطاع غزة وكما تعلمون بأن 97% من مياه الخزان الجوفي في غزة غير صالح على الاستخدام الآدمي.
So also like it will alleviate the sufferings of the our people in Gaza, especially that the reserved water there, like more than 97% of it is not usable.
وبالتأكيد أن يعني هذا المشروع كما ذكرنا يأتي في إطار التعاون الإقليمي وليس له أي انعكاسات على مفاوضات الحل النهائي الخاصة بعملية السلام في المنطقة.
So sure, this is just an agreement that is not related to any, doesn't have any reflection on political negotiations on final status issues.
ونعتقد أن إذا ما تم يعني بذل كافة الجهود واستمرار يعني بذل الجهود من قبل الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية وكافة الشركاء على مستوى العالم يمكن إيجاد حلول واقعية بناءة لمشكلة قطاع المياه وبالتالي نستطيع في هذه الحالة أن نسهل من عملية الوصول إلى حل نهائي لأن المياه هي أحد الملفات الخمسة للحل الدائم.
So sure, if such effort by the U.S. administration continues, then definitely it will have an impact on final solution to the whole water crisis here in Palestine.
طبعا وأيضا لا يفوتنا هنا إلا أن نتقدم بالشكر إلى المملكة الأردنية الهاشمية وإلى معالي وزير المياه والري دكتور حازم الناصر الذي بذل جهودا كبيرة لتقريب وجهات النظر بين الطرفين.
And sure, there's appreciation for the Jordanian government and the Minister of Water there for paying enough efforts to bring the two sides together on an agreement.
ونتطلع أيضا إلى استمرار دعم الدول المانحة لتوفير الدعم المالي والفني لتطوير البنية التحتية لاستيعاب هذه الكمية. التي سيتم التوقيع عليها في الاتفاقية لاحقا.
And we look forward for donors' support, whether it's technical or financial, so that this amount of water that will be worked on could be covered.
ونؤكد بأن الجانب الفلسطيني سيلتزم بما سيتم التوقيع عليه، وسنبدأ فورا بالعمل من اليوم التالي على كافة بنود الواردة في هذه الاتفاقية. لنستطيع أن يعني نستوعب هذه الكميات ونخفف من أزمة المياه ومعاناة أبناء شعبنا.
So we confirm that the Palestinian side will start from day one upon signing the agreement to like comply with the items mentioned there and start implementing it so that to alleviate the sufferings in the crisis of water.
وأيضا نؤكد أيضا على أن هذا الموضوع موضوع المياه تحديدا هو موضوع إنساني. بالدرجة الأولى وهو موضوع خدماتي أيضا بالدرجة الثانية وهو أيضا في حالة فلسطين موضوع سياسي.
Okay, so we confirm sure that at first level this issue of water is a humanitarian and then at a second level it is a service level effort and at third level the issue of water is a political one.
ولهذا السبب كان في هناك متابعة دائمة وحثيثة وتوجيهات مباشرة من قبل الأخ الرئيس محمود عباس ودولة رئيس الوزراء دكتور رامي الحمد الله لضرورة التقدم وإنجاز ما يمكن إنجازه في قطاع المياه.
And that's why there was all continuous follow-up and direct supervision by President Mahmoud Abbas and His Excellency Prime Minister Rami Hamdallah on the need of the Waters Authority to follow up like on this issue and solve it.
وأخيراً أنا بكرر شكري لجميع الطواقم التي عملت في سلطة المياه أو حتى الطواقم يعني الإسرائيلية اللي كانت مقابلة والذي يعني في النهاية استطعنا الوصول إلى هذه التوافقات. وكذلك شكرنا إلى الحكومة الأمريكية والسيد هنيكبي وكافة الذين ساهموا وشاركوا من أجل تذليل العقبات من أجل أن تستمر الحياة على هذه الأرض.
So in the end he reiterates his thanks to the team at the Water Authority, to the Israeli government's officials who contributed to reach these understandings, as well as to the US administration who worked on this in order to alleviate sufferings and make it a viable life on this earth.
شكرا.
Thank you.
Very much, Joe Dyke from AFP. For Mr. Greenblatt, can you hear me? Yeah, sorry. Two quick questions. Firstly, do you have are you any closer to a rough schedule for when we could be returning to direct negotiations? Are you confident that could be coming in the near future? And secondly, we've seen a series of settlement announcements in recent months, specifically Palestinians expressing growing private concern over this. Your official position is that unrestrained settlement activities...
Sorry, let me just interrupt you to save time. We're only taking questions about the Red Dead project, and it'll be answered by the two ministers here.
Okay. You should clarify. Okay. Fine. Can you clarify when we've heard about this project before? When what exactly is being advanced here, and what's the new schedule for this process?
Thank you. It can be a long lecture, but I'm going to be very, very focused on the timetable. The timetable is that there was a PQ bid, pre-qualification, several years ago. Many infrastructure companies all over the world participated. Now there are five that are relevant, and they are waiting the Jordanian government to publish a bid. Before this bid will be published, the Israeli government must make a decision very soon about the budgeting of the project from the Israeli side, and hopefully it will happen soon. And then the bid will take approximately a year, maybe less. And then the company will be chosen, and the company will start building the pipe. This is a pipe of 220 kilometers leading from Aqaba all the way to the Dead Sea. And as I said before, it's a huge, huge, I would say gigantic project that will physically be in Jordan, but will be run by what we call the JEB, which is Joint Administration Board of both Israelis and Jordanian professionals. And also the Palestinians will be part of this enterprise due to the issue of the water supply that they are supposed to purchase. All in all, I would believe that in between 4 and 5 years, the project will be finished. It's not going to take less, but this is the timetable. The water that will be supplied to the Palestinian Authority will not wait all the way 4 or 5 years, and this agreement is relevant and is actual, and it gives a price that is a result of a negotiation between the sides and with the help of the American administration. Personally, with Jason, we could reach an agreement after a long, long discussion.
Thank you. Our next question.
Yahya Qasim from Al-Hurra TV. Gentlemen, this question for you all. We know that both sides are very skeptic regarding the peace process. How this agreement can bridge the gap between the Palestinians and the Israeli, while the Israeli coalition still refuse a Palestinian state, and the Palestinians still divided.
Sorry again, I have to remind the press, we're here to discuss the project, we're not here to discuss the peace process, so let's refrain from asking.
I'm talking about the project.
Okay, but the two are not connected, so let's just discuss questions about the project itself.
Thank you. I'm done.
Hello. A question for both ministers. How would you advise from this constructive dialogue that you have just had on this very important issue of water? How would you advise negotiators? How would you move forward to another process? What lessons can you learn from these negotiations to a process? And the other question is for Minister Tzachi Hanegbi and for both of you. Do you think both your leaders can sit down and have a similar dialogue on political issues? If we see these two both very important agreements signed this week, what needs to be done to move from the economic and civil level to the political level?
Well, I think it's a very creative way to connect the project to other issues. And I'm not authorized to relate to other issues, but I think what we can learn from this process that we have been through in the last several months is that when you focus on the issues and not about history or background or personal emotions or other disturbing elements, so the common denominator is much bigger than what separates us. So even though for years this issue was not challenged in the right way, since Jason was introduced to it, I think he managed to help us find the way to reach an agreement that is mutually beneficial. I think another lesson is the discrete nature of the negotiation. I didn't hold any press conferences, neither Jason or Minister Naim. We just worked with our teams in order to make sure that we understand what the obstacles are, and whenever we found a solution to the obstacles, we solved it. So it was not on Facebook, it was not on the media. I'm sure many of you maybe heard about it, but not because we approached you and asked you to publish it. So if I would have to advise my friend Jason that it has bigger issues than this issue, how to relate to it, I think that the less public nature of negotiation ensures that it's more serious and it's not being dragged to other problems.
ترجم السؤال لحضرتك. هي سألت الصحفية إنه إيش الدروس المستفادة من جانب إداري في تطبيقكم لهي الاتفاقية وكيف ممكن أنتوا تعكسوها على صناع القرار؟ كيف ممكن تعطوهم إياها كنموذج مماثل يحتذى به؟
سؤال جيد.
It's a good question.
يعني أول شيء أعتقد إنه يجب أن تتوفر الإرادة لدى الأطراف كافة وبعد ذلك يمكن التفاهم والوصول إلى تفاهمات.
So first of all, as a beginning, first level understanding, there should be agreement between all sides concerned in any agreement that they want to reach an agreement. That this is the basic understanding. We want to reach an agreement and then move from there.
وكل اتفاق هو بحاجة إلى مرجعية.
Every agreement needs a reference.
ومرجعية هذا التوافق الذي حصل هو مذكرة التفاهم اللي تم توقيعها في عام 2013 في واشنطن.
Our reference is the memorandum of understanding which was signed in Washington in 2013.
أنا أقول باختصار أن هناك فرص للسلام في هذه المنطقة إذا ما التزمنا واحترمنا كافة المواثيق الدولية وقرارات الشرعية الدولية بالخصوص.
In a nutshell, briefly, he thinks that if we abide to all the international resolutions, then an agreement could be reached.
وبالتأكيد إنه يجب أن يكون في هناك أيضا يعني راعي لهذه العملية.
Surely there should be a supervisor for this process.
وأن يكون في هناك محاولات دائما لتقريب وجهات النظر، أو أحيانا بيكون في هناك بعض القضايا اللي بتكون خلافية نتيجة عدم وضوح في النصوص أو عدم فهم حقيقي إلها من كافة المتعاورين.
Those supervisors will have a role or to bring the two sides understanding one another, or in case there is a misunderstanding, mistranslation of any concept, kind of clarify it. So to bring points of views nearer to one another.
بالتالي احنا سنعمل مع كافة الأطراف الفلسطينية أيضا من أجل محاولة نقل ما حصل في هذه التجربة، وأيضا بنأكد على استمرار السيد غرين بلات اللي احنا نتمنى له التوفيق في هذه المهمة الشاقة والسهلة في نفس الوقت.
And so we will try our best to convey this model to our Palestinian side and at the same time convey appreciation to Mr. Greenblatt in his tiring yet tiring yet easy process.
This is our last question.
I am Elias from Al Jazeera. My question will be to Mr. Mazen. سؤال أستاذ مازن، لماذا على السلطة الوطنية الفلسطينية أن تدفع مقابل هذه المياه في حين أن إسرائيل تسيطر على كل منابع المياه في الضفة الغربية، تزود المستوطنات الإسرائيلية بها وتحرم الكثير من البلدات الفلسطينية من هذه الحصص من المياه؟ سؤال آخر، هل هذه الاتفاقية تقر في حق الفلسطينيين بالمشاطئة على البحر الميت؟ شكرا.
So the first question is, why does the Palestinians have to pay for their own waters when the Israeli government provides that water to settlements and projects of its own? And the other project, will the Palestinians have a share in the Dead Sea as part of this project?
يعني احنا شوف اول اشي تحدثنا بأن هذه الاتفاقية هي تأتي في إطار تعاون إقليمي لا علاقة له بمفاوضات الحل النهائي وبالحقوق المائية الفلسطينية.
So first of all, we clarified that this is a regional agreement that has nothing to do with final status negotiations or Palestinians' rights on water.
ثاني شيء، يعني الحقوق في المياه لا تعني بأي حال من الأحوال بأنها مجانية.
Rights to water doesn't mean at all that it should be for free.
يعني عند عملية استخراج المياه في هناك نفقات وتكلفة لعملية استخراج المياه وضخها.
When we execute and pump water, there are costs for doing this process.
حتى لكل المصادر الطبيعية ليس فقط المياه.
For any natural sources, not only water.
وبالتالي إحنا كان الحديث أن تتم دفع الأسعار التي تكون تقريبا التكاليف تكلفة بسعر التكلفة.
So at we agreed to pay at least the minimum cost for this process.
The cost.
Yes. Yeah, the costs for this process.
بالتالي هي يعني إحنا على فكرة يعني هذا موضوع بياخذنا لقضية تانية على مستوى العالم كله. المياه تحديدا هي خدمة إنسانية غير مسموح التربح فيها لأي جهة كانت.
Generally worldwide water as a topic or a theme is a humanitarian topic and at all not profitable worldwide.
وبالتالي عملية الدفع هي دفع للتكاليف وليست أرباح.
And therefore whatever we pay it's just for the costs, not any